people to write. The writing platform is there, but nobody has been utilizing it, except for some writers and authors like us who are already established. They have been using it, but somehow we were not getting used to it. So I thought that it's the best way to encourage the upcoming writers, not necessarily with the age, those who have the feelings in their mind, those who have the zeal to write, they should be given a platform. So we started with this platform of writing, and with that we had a contest in the beginning, somewhere in the year 2019, and that is how Andrew Scott, who is a author himself, has published several books. I got associated with him, so sir is here already. So can we have a big round of applause, at least a virtual one, where we can see for our guest. So the virtual for our guest, Chief Guest Andrew Scott, who has been always supporting creating modeling, and always in this venture. He was a judge for the event, and he had selected the writers. I request all of you to keep your cameras on. That would give, since it's everything virtual, I have tried to use a virtual background with a book little bit. I don't know, somehow technology I don't understand much properly, but somehow the book cover page, I tried to keep it as the virtual background. That is how we are going to do the book launch. Actually, that's the cover page of our book, The Chosen One, Volume 1. So the volume one is published. So I want to encourage others to come up, those who were not there. We have some young writers with us today. Raj, Darji, Sneha Pandey, they are the writers of our book. So welcome to all of you. And I have invited many of our young friends who really love to write, that so that they get encouraged. We have a platform ready for you. You just have to write and get it published. It's a Facebook page. We have an Instagram also. Do like and share your posts there. Raj is always there as an helping hand, is the moderator of the group too. Raj, welcome. Racheta is also a writer there, constant helping us with articles and materials. So today's book launch, we'll start with it. I would like to present the book. I was just waiting for one of our guests to join in, because it was at a very short notice. I was with this pandemic, we were not accessible to anything properly, but finally I got the book in my hand. This is the copy of the book, which is there. So I'll be showing everything inside what is there. Andrew Scott has written a lovely article there for the young children, the young winners. So I would love to read that, or I would ask sir to read his viewpoint about the winners of the competition. So within a short while we'll be connecting. Yes. So going across to this book, we had an editor to the book. It is a compilation. So in the first page, you can see edited by Ajaya Chakravarti. So there is no such particular author for the book, because it is a collection of all the poets and authors, which we have done through various events. Most admired writer of the month. So accordingly, we had tried to get a lot of amazing authors and writers. Please do keep your cameras on, those who are there in the book launch. So a small story behind this Creative Writing Modern Age I'll share, then I'll forward it to our chief guest to speak about his experience with the poems when he read it. So what is this CWMA? Which we call it Creative Writing Modern Age. It actually started some years ago when I was very pensive, and it was then that I thought that I should start writing to express, and hence ended up making this Facebook group. In course of time, I discovered that there were many ailing souls like me. And slowly we became a huge group where now we share our feelings through our writing. This gave me solace and we started motivating writers to write and also read out their own composed poems. The group Creative Writing Modern Age intends to give all the authors a non-judgmental space to vent out their feelings and enhance the positive vibes. The literary contests are only for motivating writers to express themselves with the spoken words. So this was the main story of our creative writing team, how we encourage the writers to come up. Our guest has not yet arrived. Oh, no guest, she's also a writer. So I had invited her anyway. It was a short notice. So I would ask Andrew Scott, who is our chief guest, sir, please can you share your experience with the young upcoming writers and what they should do, and especially your experience judging this contest which was organized. So, sir, over to you. Sir, you need to unmute yourself. We are not able to hear.
I was saying it was a lot of fun because I found that as you get older and you write more, you think too much. So when the younger writers were writing, it was refreshing to read spontaneity, their pure thoughts, not overthinking it. And it was a lot of fun, and it was extremely great to see how many talented writers were out there all over the world. And it was a privilege for them to be shared with me, because I have to give kudos. It is very difficult to share your work and for other people to read your work, because there's a certain amount of honesty in it. And these are your feelings and your thoughts. And so everybody should be extremely proud of themselves for doing so. To me, it was a privilege, and I thank everybody for letting me read their works.
Thank you so much, sir. That was really very, very encouraging. And I hope our young writers are already here who can understand their feelings, that it is not just a platform and you have been judged by an author like Andrew Scott, who is himself so much experienced and he has published so many books. So it's not that easy to be judged by him, and he has given his time, ample of time, with lot of feedbacks to the young writers as well as the upcoming writers. Not only we here are not going by age, it's by the feelings and the moments which we are sharing with our viewers. So with that, we are very happy that you all have coped up with that and you have come up to that level. So we have some of the writers here, though we couldn't get across some. I'll just name all the writers' poems which are here so that we don't miss out anyone. So we have Racheta Chakravarti, her poem has been published. Then we have Raj Darji, his poem is also published here. Then we have Diana Leanne Thomas, she is today not here. Diana Leanne Thomas. Then we have Greg Welling. His poem is also published in our book. Then we have Grant Voss. His poem is also published. Then we have Sunita. Poem is also published. Sneha Pandey. Her poem is also published here. So it's really a proud moment for all of us that so many poems, and of course our judge Andrew Scott has also given us one poem which we have published it. We have one of his poems, though he has written many poems, but one poem he had shared with us, and that was The Unwavering Faith. So that poem of yours is also here, The Unwavering Faith. So that is the poem which we had published, The Unwavering Faith. So that is also here. And even I had given one of my poem, The Fading Hue, that is also there. So I would love if our young writers would read out one of their poems, since we have more upcoming writers here. So I would love that if you could read it. So first I would ask Raj, our guest, a writer and as well as a guest, to read out the poem, one of the poems. I think three poems, Raj, is published here in the book. Three of your poems are there.
Yes, miss.
So you can read any of the poem which you feel. So please do read one of the poem. And that will
Hello,
be
everyone.
An inspiration. Yeah. Okay, over to you, Raj.
Thank you, Miss. First, hello, everyone. This is my poem, which I like the most, which is We Seek, We Hide. I see setting sun every day, making way for moon and stars. The clock keeps ticking, humans still finding an escape from this world, which is truly harsh. Make acceptance a habit. No question should be asked. Inheritance with a surrounding, a part of the crowd, where everything is hidden behind a mask. Every concrete wall has been designed after destroying the natural beauty which resides. Amplifies human state of mind. Never seen the burning flames of their demise. It's true we haven't seen reality because we tend to hide. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, Raj. Amazing to hear from you. And if the poet himself is reciting his own poem, that's the most wonderful thing. Then I would request Sneha Pandey to read out her poem, which was published. So over to you, Sneha Pandey. Sneha Pandey, you can unmute yourself and then start reading. Yes, Sneha, we couldn't hear you. Please, can you start?
Yes, ma'am.
Still, I can't hear you, Sneha. Some mic problem is there. Just check out. I'm not able to hear you.
Hello.
Yes, that's better.
I still remember I cried a lot of tears when mummy first brought me here. Mama said it's paramount, my dear, one day you will miss each day here. Now I understand mummy was right. Every day I learned to write made my future more bright. My school gave me new sight for looking the world upright. Fun in the recess and lecture, writing names on school's furniture, making designs in textbook pictures, and not doing homework for adventure, but were the beautiful memories I captured. Every lessons my teachers gave was for making me more courageous and brave. It took me out of ignorance cave and taught me manners for how to behave. Living with friends in school are the best memories from my moment school. I used my learnings as a tool. This is what I learned from school. I wish I can again go to school. Thank you.
Wow, Sneha. Awesome, that was amazing to hear from you.
Thank you.
Very nice, wonderful. So we heard our two of our poets. Then we have also Racheta Chakravarti. So I would request Racheta if she could read out one of her poem which was published in the book. So over to you, Racheta.
First of all, I would like to thank you, ma'am, for the introduction. And my poem is called The Evil With Itself Go. The evil has taken birth. Dear my good Appa, I'm wasting my time to the evil in every soul without knowing that thing somewhere near me. Things never work as I plan. Nervous, shy, and fear things which is taped with my name. I want to shine like my idol. But I guess the evil which is some of my eyes will never let the bad go. I look in the mirror to see if I can. But when it comes to my action, my leg steps behind. I wonder, where is the evil hiding? I searched inside every being I ever met. Maybe the evil minding in their minds to drag me down, but my investment failed. And now I wondered, where is the hiding? One day, my foolish mind said evil. I tried like the movie, I became, but still, the evil made no response. Then again, I looked at the mirror to see if I can. This time, I saw a shade which was coming from inside my body. I didn't know if it was haunted or not, but it said to me, what are you is in you. The evil is no one but your neck. As you become weak, it makes the evil more strong. Throw out every weaknesses, the evil will itself go. Then, the evil was not hiding. It's inside my soul, holding me back. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Racheta. That was amazing. It was wonderful to hear from the young poets. So actually, I had done a mistake here. My guest had just now told me that I didn't send her the link. So it was like my mistake, and that is why our guest was not able to join. So I just now sent her the link. She'll be joining in. That's truly like all of a sudden we had to do it. Yeah, she's here now already. So our chief guest, we had two chief guests today. She's just joining in. I had not sent her the link. It's my mistake. I don't know how I forgot to send her the link. So she's here. I'll just give her one big round of virtual applause once she gets connected to us. She's trying to connect. So we had only two chief guests today for the book launch. Andrew Scott, sir, author and writer himself, and Leslie Tripathi. She is an actress. So welcome, Leslie ma'am. Welcome, virtual clap, all of you, please. I would request, please welcome ma'am with a big round of applause. So we were actually waiting, and it's my mistake. I completely take that in me. I forgot to send you, I don't know how, the link. And here we were waiting for you. And here I was telling, ma'am will join now. So it's totally, thanks that you just reminded me with the message, and I was just going through the message. Thank you so much. So we had actually started, we have another chief guest, author and writer, Andrew Scott. He is an international writer and author. So we had actually started, a little bit we had done, and some of our young writers had already recited their poem. So welcome, and let me introduce you a little bit about Leslie ma'am. She is a writer, though she is a Bollywood actress, but she loves to write. So that is why today I have invited her for the meet. So welcome, Leslie ma'am. So, can you please tell us something about your writing career so that we can encourage our young writers to come up and write more, because that is missing nowadays. We search the net, we surf many things, but writing has only been with some few. So if you could please tell us, ma'am, something.
Hi, Rachna ji. Thank you so much. It's an honor to be part of your Zoom meeting. And I'm an actress. I started my career as an actress, but before that, I was a debater. I was a state level debater when I was growing up in Orissa. I was debating on national level. I was bringing applause for my school, for my college, for my community, for my state. It made me feel I have so much to offer. And again, like, students have this thing going in their lives. They are not always doing great in all subjects. I was always excelling in English because I come from a family of professors. Both of them are English professors, teachers, professors. So what happened is I was faltering in maths and science. But, you know, in my life, I have always had the determination to always make a name for myself, to make everybody proud of myself. So I wrote a book. This is the book, Because I'm a Girl. So it has a lot of interesting moments that I experienced as an actor, as a girl. So I thought, like, you know, as every kid who is growing up but has big dreams, I also had big dreams of becoming a Bollywood actor. But, you know, as it happens, while I was in Orissa, everybody was like, oh, you can't make it, you don't have it. So, you know, at times I felt like, okay, am I not worth it? Maybe they're right. You know, somewhere I was taking all this feedback and I was, you know, my blossoming years, I was like, you know, maturing. Okay. So what happened is I started reading and writing, as you know, you are emphasizing on the importance of reading, writing. So I started writing my things, what's important to me. I used to write, you are special, I'm special. If they don't get me, I really don't care. I know I'm special. Someday they will get it. Someday they will understand I'm special. I'm meant for bigger things. So I started writing poems. I started participating in bigger level debates, TV panel discussions and stuff. Then people started noticing that. I got offers to act in Oriya, all those big ads, commercials. I became a big face. I became a very famous name in Orissa. And then I also use my platform for good causes like planting trees, visiting old age homes. So what was happening is people who liked me, they also did this more. Whoever didn't like me, they were like hating me and they wanted to outshine me. So they also did that. So in a way, education has groomed my youth. Like, I would like to say that, because when you read books, when you write what's inside your heart, it opens doors for me. So, as I said, I didn't have anybody in Mumbai who was a relative to show me a path at whose place I could come or take guidance. So, it was all my dreams manifesting into truth. I dreamt one day that, you know, I will be known as on a national level, international level. And slowly it started happening. In Orissa, what happened is there was a Hollywood film team. It was called A Woman from Georgia. They had come looking for some actors who can speak English. And again, it worked for me. It came in my favor. I was recommended to be part of that film. It was not a big role, but it was a small role. But anyways, it made news headlines in Orissa. So, you know, small things like this helped me. A lot of my co-stars, while I was acting in Orissa and other cities I've seen, they have never given education a priority. But the fact that I come from a family of educationists and writers, my father is also a writer. So what happens is I knew the importance of education. You know, because of education, I could stand tall. I can handle anything, anywhere. Slowly, slowly, that worked for me. I came to Bombay. I acted in a film called W. W as in W for woman. And that was a dream come true moment. So, you know, these things, I will say, is all manifestation and believing in miracles and magic. And you know how it all comes into our lives? It's because we believe in books, we read them. There are authors who have dreamt of all those moments, they have experienced it. So I came about, right, I wrote everything in this book. You know, like when I was a 16-year-old girl, I was getting so many offers, I was replacing so many actresses. Then when I was 20-year-old, I was being replaced, okay, so you know, by other girls who were 15 or 16. So, you know, these are things that were bothering me, like, you know, am I old? Am I being rejected in the industry because I'm just 4 years older than some, you know, young, fresh face? So, a lot of things come to our mind. We go through so much and we're not able to discuss this with anyone, but writing helped me. You know, I could vent it out, and whenever I would write something, I tell you, magic happens in my life. So that ways I have survived a lot of things, and during this lockdown I've written a lot of more things, and I've gone ahead. I also have a show called Leslie Show. It's on Instagram, it's on YouTube. It's going well, and it's all because, you know, I can communicate, I can speak well. So I think importance of education is so important. And I'm very happy you have this discussion going on, and you're inspiring students to study, to write, to read. I'm very happy to be part of it.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for sharing your experience as a writer. So with that note, we'll once again take the book. The book launch is about this book, which was written by all the young writers. This is the cover page. So can we have a big round of applause for the book, which we got it published, and because of which we are here today. This is the book, and the back cover is looking like this. The back cover of it. It is having CWMA, that is the group's name where we are publishing, and because of whom. We have a foreword and a note. I would love to read it out. It is a thank you note written by our editor. We are missing our editor who had compiled it and managed it, Ajaya Chakravarti. She has written that. And our acknowledgements goes. So I would like to read it up to that acknowledgement part. The Chosen One is a compilation of poems by several poets across the globe. Creative Writing Modern Age believes that every poet is a unique in themselves. We truly acknowledge their creativity and the skill they pursue. We would like to extend our thanks to our proofreaders and editors who had helped us in this venture. We would also like to thank our publisher, Notion Press, for giving us this platform to publish our work. We are immensely grateful to our founder, Mrs. Rachna Chakravarti, who had conceptualized the amazing platform which motivates and encourages freelance poets and writers across the globe to express themselves exuberantly with the help of spoken words. We are immensely thankful to Andrew Scott for giving us time and patience to judge the poet's contribution and motivating them to express their thoughts at the best possible. So this was a little bit of from the book, and I would request all of you to get a copy of it. If possible, you will get to see more upcoming poets there, and you will enjoy reading them. So it is available in Amazon. The links I will share it afterwards, so you can get it and read it for yourself. Now I would request Andrew sir to tell us something. What should a writer, upcoming writer, should keep in mind when they are writing? So what are the points which they should keep it in mind? So Andrew sir.
Pardon?
Sir, I wanted to ask you that. What are the points which an upcoming writer should keep in mind when they are starting to write something, when they want to write something?
Write from the heart and be honest. You know, if you have an idea, try to not be fearful to write it down. It is extremely hard once you start writing to be completely honest about it, but write what you know. Because if you write something that you don't know, it will be very apparent when the reader reads it. And also write for yourself and understand that the reader will relate later on. But be fearless more than anything.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Sir, could you read out the poem which we published at your... The Unwavering Faith for our young writers, the upcoming writers, The Unwavering Faith is published. So if you could read that poem out, your own composed poem.
Give me a sec. And here we go. This is a little story for you all. She sits on her front porch looking up and down the quiet lit street. Edna has been sitting there for 3 days, morning, noon, and night. Her son has left a few days ago, and she fears that he may succumb to an old addiction. Edna has seen this dance before and knows that sometime he may not return from the stimulation. And in Edna's mind, that is not today. Her unwavering faith repeats this. Gerald paces around his kitchen before sitting back down to face his computer screen, waiting for messages to come in. He has not worked in 7 months, not since his place of employment unexpectedly shut his doors, leaving bills that have been piling and 2 other matters to feed. The stress has been all through the shaky foundation of the home. Someday, Gerald feels like he has failed everyone. However, the search for work is daily. The message of a job will come. That is his unwavering faith each day. Gloria and Sam silently staring off into the sky through a window. They have not spoken affectionately for an extended period of time. Been married for 19 years, willing their way to 20. There was once love and romance. Neither of them know when the breakdown happened between them. They both play these days as support and memories of their mind. Gloria and Sam do hope for the day hand-holding does come back. To them, that could be any day. Their dance of unwavering faith says that. And that is the poem.
Thank you so much, sir, for reading it out for us. So that was Andrew Scott, the writer himself, the author and writer. He has published several books. So thank you, sir, for joining us at the short notice. Please, all of you, all our guests and guests of our chief guests, I would request to just have a, this is the cover page of a book which I'm using it. We have several poets, young poets coming up, talented poets who can use the platform for writing and getting published. And this platform should be utilized by many poets because it was on a short notice. Though virtual, I wanted it to go bang on for our young writers especially. And to motivate them more, this platform has been created. So that they can come up with their new ideas and give it a blast. So that is what I feel. And any young writers, upcoming writers, would you like to share any of your views about the book launch? Anyone would love to share? Okay, that's fine. But only the main intention of our platform, Creative Writing Modern Age, is to encourage young writers. So, Leslie, ma'am, can you please give an ending note that why should the young children start writing at a younger age? Though there is no age for writing, at any age we can start writing. I believe that as a writer myself, that there is no particular age that we should start at the age of 5, at the age of 10. There is no particular age. But why should we write? Why is that writing part very important? Nowadays, we are all virtual, all technology and all. But why that writing is important? Can you please tell us in just a few minutes? With that ending note, we'll end today's book launch.
Hi everyone, chief guest Andrew Scott and Rachna Chakrabarti ji. Congratulations on your book launch today. I would like to say you are doing a great job and taking this amazing initiative, grooming this young minds. I saw so many of them are seated here listening to us. Writing is so important because, you know, when we are growing up, we have so many imaginary worlds we live in. And it's important to be part of those worlds and give them a go. Like what happens is usually a lot of people tell us you can't do this, you can't do that, you can't be this. But you know, we believe that we can do it. And you know, we all believe in the beauty of our dreams. Some of us are rebels. We do not listen to what others say. Some of us listen and you know, form our like a path according to what others tell us to do that, you know, we are good at or we are not good at. So writing in a way, as I told you, it helps you create your own path. It gives you clarity of thoughts. And, you know, most of your dreams will come true, especially after 2-3 years when you're looking back at your thoughts, you'll see, wow, how innocent, how creative, how innovative was I. So it's a leeway for you to make your mark and always stand out from the crowd, you know, because these days people have lost interest in writing. They're only watching stuff. They want everything instant. They don't have time to write it also. People are, you know, sending you audio messages because they don't have time to type. But, you know, typing and writing is giving power to your thoughts, imagination, and you never know. You know, I have learned a lot of things from my friends, from my seniors. If you write things in affirmations, what do you want in your life? Like, I want to say I want to be the greatest actor alive. And if I write it like every day for like 10 times, it's an affirmation. I'm telling my soul, I'm a divine soul. You know, if I write stuff like that. So, you know, whatever good things you want in your life, not anything bad, don't harm anyone, but, you know, for yourself, becoming the best version of kids, easy. Like, you know, when I was a kid, I was looking for role models, but I realized I can be my own role model. I can be leading by example. How? When I started writing, I saw I am unique, I'm different, because I started appreciating myself. So, you know, writing helps you become a mirror to yourself in life, because lot of people you will come in life who will tell you, oh, you're not good enough, you're not good, you're not this, that, you know, they'll always compare. Like, you know, when we are actors, when we are starting on ourselves, we don't have anybody in the industry to guide or groom us. People will be comparing us to all those top actors who have maybe coming. Usually, Rachna ji, what I have experienced is, like, I see lot of youngsters here who might be very shy, who don't know what to say when, like, you know, somebody is rude to them, or how to handle situations. You know, you get all your answers when you start writing, and you talk to people who are bright, like Rachna ma'am, I believe. So, you know, the more you speak to them, talk to them, tell your ideas, you know, a lot of answers come to your mind. Because when I was growing up, and when I see them, I can see it, that I was so confused. I didn't know what was the purpose of my life, everything. So I was sitting down, writing down. At times I would pose questions. What is the purpose of my life? Why am I here? And, you know, I started getting answers. I'll also, whatever answers were coming to my mind, I'll write it down. So, you know, everything is possible. And, you know, I think you become better versions of yourself. Whatever you are now, you will be so much better, happier. And, you know, I got another answer in my life, Rachna ji, is, you know, the most important thing in life is to be happy. Because I hope everybody, all of you, have this as a goal in life. Because, you know, if you want to be the happiest person alive, then you know you have everything that you want around you. You're satisfied, you're content. Because if we say, I want to be the richest, at times we might be the richest, but we might be the saddest person, because somebody's trying to, you know, take away the money we have, or maybe you have made money illegally and might be in jail. So, you know, always make this goal in your life that I've learned and that I practice. I want to be the happiest person alive, because when I say I'm happiest, I know I have done something right. I am not doing anything illegal. I have everything that I want around me. I'm content with life. So, happiest person means he is not lying to himself. You know, at times, you know, we have to be happy internally, because we know at times, like we are saying, when you ask me, at times I tell you, I'm okay, you know. But, you know, if I know I'm happy, I know I'm happy. So, you know, it's very important to have a great relationship with yourself. Talk to the mirror. You know, talking to the mirror is the best thing you can do. And write down whatever comes to your mind. You know, I have, like, on my phone, I write down. Like, at times I use a diary. But, you know, diary, koi padh leta hai, stuff like that. So it's not always easy to carry. Also, like, you guys have bags to carry and all, but we girls have like a chota sa purse to carry with our, you know, whatever outfits. So what I do is I use my phone notes. you know, you must be having notes in your phones. Use that, and I use date wise whatever interesting thing has happened. So I have a section in my notes for miracles of the day or of the week, and you know, things that interesting events that have happened in my life. So right now the thing is that I have always thought of myself or groomed myself to believe I'm important, I'm doing this, that. So what is happening is a lot of doors are opening for me. You know, in my show, when I'm interviewing people, I'm just not interviewing Indian people. I'm having friends from America, Africa, New Zealand, you know, I mean, they're rappers, actors, they are all showing so much interest for my show because, you know, I believe that, you know, I can communicate well. I, you know, it's all me. I thought it all and I presented myself to the world. So, but it was all possible when I talked to myself in the mirror or talked to myself in the camera of the phone, if I don't have a mirror with me, and writing it down. I have like diaries full of content I've written, and it's not necessary that for me to go read it back, but you know, I have written my heart's thought, you know, best desire, my dreams, what I want to be when I'm 50 years old, when I'm 100 years old, or after I'm dead, you know, whatever, all I want. So in a way, make that happen, things will happen for you, dreams, you know, will come true, doors will open for you. I tell you that. And you know who follows me on Twitter? Barack Obama, the former president of America. I have, because I wrote something on Black Lives, not now. Black Lives Matter is a thing now, but in my college, for my journalism project for BBC, I was studying in a BBC school. I wrote a project on Black Lives. Not exactly like that. I wrote why Oprah Winfrey is one of the biggest names in America, being a Black woman. And I compared her journey to like years back, how they were oppressed, Black people oppressed. So, you know, I made a comparison study in my dissertation and I celebrated Obama and Oprah. So after that, Obama followed me on Twitter. So, you know, all this is possible. These are small achievements. This is nothing major, but you know, important for me, for my friends, you know, and this is all happening because, you know, we give wings to our thoughts, and that's through writing.
Thank you. Amazing. I think that note will help even the viewers who will be watching us when we are posting this. You all can hear what Leslie ma'am has said, and to encourage and motivate, as well as what Andrew sir had said about the young writers as well as the upcoming writers, that there is no age for writing. Thus, you just need to vent out your thoughts and empty your brain and start writing. Just give it a blast to your thoughts. Don't think what will others judge about it. So with that note, we'll declare that the book is completely out for everyone to buy it. It's available at Amazon. So you can get your copy, handbook, and you can post it with a copy, holding it in your hand. And then you can tag Creative Writing Modern Age once you buy the book. And you can just tag us with that. We have a wonderful collection of poems written by young poets, as well as experienced poets about their lifestyle. So you will get a glimpse of it. So Andrew sir, lastly, I would like to ask you, any other experience with this platform, Creative Writing Modern Age, would you like to share with our upcoming writers, whoever is watching us? They will also get to know what is your experience joining with Creative Writing Modern Age. Can you please share your experience with us? You have been with us since quite a long time, I think 2 years from now. So if you could please share your experience with Creative Writing Modern Age. Andrew sir, can you hear me, sir?
Oh yes, sorry. No, my experience has been great, and reading, it's like I said, reading the young person's poems where their creative mind and they're working out their emotions and answering their own questions while putting out there something of, that is part of their history, it's been phenomenal. It's great to see young people write. It's great to see anybody write. And the fact that they're doing it so honestly and purely is exceptional.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Those are very kind of you. So please do join the platform and start writing. This is just the volume one. We will have a lot of volumes like this. This is the volume one written by collected poems. So can we have a virtual clap once again for the book launch? And with that, we can end the meet, today's meet. And thank you so much at short notice, Leslie ma'am and Andrew sir. It's I think early morning there, I think 6 o'clock in Canada right now, it's 6 a.m. but still is so kind to join us, got up early morning only for us so that we could have the book launch properly, and without him, he's a guiding star of the platform. So thank you so much, sir, from the bottom of our heart. Creative Writing Modern Age would like to thank you, as well as the young stars today, Neha Pandey, Raj Darji and Racheta. Thank you so much for giving your wonderful poems for our book and making our book get published. So do keep sharing. Others too can join in this venture. We are having our most admired writer of the month. We have contests been going on. So do join in and share your write-ups and your writings too with our in our platform and get published yourself also. So thank you so much, Leslie ma'am. She was busy in an interview just before that. And here I was waiting for her, but I didn't send her the link. So how would she join in? And we were waiting for her here. And I was just telling that ma'am is joining. And I finally realized that I didn't send you the link only. So it is my fault. Sorry for that once again. So thank you very much for joining in. And thank you all my children who has joined in, the young writers, the upcoming writers. We'll have more such good writers. We have heard from all our experienced writers. Leslie ma'am is also a writer. She has published so many books. And even Andrew sir is already an author and publisher, a poet. Barrister recently has published the book. So if you have the book, you can show our audience. They can see your book, which he has published very recently. Just a week ago, it was published and it is out in the market now. This is the new books. The Whispers of Calm. Amazing, amazing it is. I had read the poems, so it was amazing collection of poems. So it's very nice. You all should all get a glimpse of it. So thank you so much once again, all of you, for joining in at a short notice. So we'll end the meeting on that note. Okay. Bye, bye, bye. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Leslie, ma'am. Thank you, our young writers. Neha is not there. Racheta and Raj, thank you so much. Yes, so children, did you all enjoy?
This is just write whatever you feel and keep tagging me and posting on the CWMA page. It's great to write. You can express whatever you feel. It's simple, simple words, simple meaning. Just it should be relatable. You should be happy with your work. You should feel light. You should feel relatable. And every day just try to write something, a page or one or two lines. It would be great. So I hope to see your poems in CWMA page soon. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, Raj, for those inspiring words. So you all can do it. If we can do, you all can do. So start writing. Racheta, also thank you very much. So thank you all for joining in. Thank you so much. All of you, thank you very much. Bye, all of you.